Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm pleased to present you today our study and first results of the cortical distribution of the femoral neck in Australopithecus africanus in comparison to the already published evidence of Paranthropus robustus and the taxonomic and biomechanical perspectives of the study. Given the ability of the cortical and trabecular tissues to respond to the loading environment, the reconstruction of the locomotor repertoire of Australopith, including Australopithecus and Paranthropus, has increasingly integrated information from the inner structure of the appendicular skeleton. There has been a particular focus on the internal structure of the hip joint because of its critical role in locomotion. The asymmetrical distribution of the cortical bone in the femoral neck, with thinner superior and thicker inferior cortex, has been shown to characterize bipedal humans. In Australopith, the combination of a human-like superior-inferior asymmetry at the base of neck and the less asymmetric distribution at mid-neck has been interpreted as a commitment to terrestrial bipedalism associated with a slightly altered gait kinematics compared to Homo. In a recent microtomographic analysis, we also identified in Paranthropus robustus a human-like trend of lateral to medial decrease in superior-inferior asymmetry and accentuated contrast between the relatively thicker anterior and the thinner posterior walls and the marked lateral to medial thinning of both cortices. However, it's still unknown whether and to what extent these features also characterize Australopithecus. The present study aims at assessing the cortical bone distribution along the femoral neck of early hominin specimens from South Africa and compare the signal to the published evidence of Paranthropus robustus. Given previous evidence for variation in climbing frequency and or in bipedal kinematics between early hominins, we predict that a refined assessment of the Australopithecus africanus femoral neck cortical distribution has the potential to reveal gait-related differences with respect to Paranthropus robustus. We investigated two proximal femora from Sterkenden caves in South Africa, STW479 from member 4 attributed to Australopithecus africanus, and STW311 from member 5 recently suggested to represent either early Homo or Paranthropus robustus. Both fossils are housed and were scanned at the University of the Witwatersrand in South Africa at a resolution of about 30 microns. We compared their functional signals to the evidence from the Paranthropus robustus specimen SK82 from Swartkrans in South Africa, 25 humans and 8 chimpanzees. A virtual extraction of the neck followed by automatic segmentation has been carried out. Due to differences in preservation, we extracted a set of slices at regular intervals from the base of neck to 70% of the total neck length in STW479 and one at mid-neck of STW311. Superior and inferior cortical thicknesses and their ratio have been measured for each slice of the neck. Additionally, the average cortical thickness has been measured for the superior, inferior, anterior, and posterior quadrants. The base of neck and mid-neck were specifically considered. STW479 shares with SK82 a superior-inferior asymmetry in cortical thickness at the base of neck. However, while SK82 has a less asymmetric ratio than in humans, especially at mid-neck, STW479 shows a human-like distribution. Such human-like condition is confirmed all along the assessed portion of the femoral neck. The Australopithecus africanus specimen share with SK82 and the humans a trend for lateral to medial increase in this ratio. Conversely, Pan exhibits an opposite pattern. In addition, relatively thicker posterior and thinner anterior walls are identified in STW479, while an opposite pattern is observed in SK82, and the cortex asymmetry is nearly absent in extant humans and in chimpanzees. At the mid-neck, STW311 shows a human-like asymmetry as well as a posterior reinforcement relatively to the anterior quadrant, as observed in STW479 and differently from the condition in SK82. We can also notice that SKAT2 is more posterior-anteriorly compressed. Our results provide new taxonomic and biomechanical insights of early hominins. Indeed, while the superior-inferior asymmetry in cortical thickness at the base of neck that decreases lateromedially in STW479, SKAT2 and the extentuments are thought to reflect habitual bipedal locomotion, as previously suggested for the trabecular organization of other skeletal elements, the differences in cortical thickness between STW479 and SKAT2 might reflect differences in locomotor-related biomechanical environment between Australopithecus africanus and Paranthropus robustus. The similar cortical distribution at the mid-neck in STW311 and the Australopithecus specimen STW479 is intriguing, given that the trabecular bone distribution of its head differs from the condition of the Australopithecus specimen STW522. Further investigations are therefore needed. In addition, further analyses are required to better understand the functional origin of the identified differences between STW479 and SKAT2, notably the anterior versus posterior cortical thickness, the morphological variation of the endosteal and periosteal contour, as well as the cross-sectional geometric properties might provide further information. We would like to sincerely thank all colleagues, collaborators, and institutions who contributed to the present study, and thank you for your kind attention.